So this week on PowerCat Live, if you've ever wished you had access to the server logs behind your apps, now you do. And JinMan and Varda are going to tell you how, for your model-driven apps, you can see what's happening on our servers and improve the performance on your model-driven apps. Welcome to PowerCat Live. I'm Phil Thomas with the PowerCat team, and I'm here with Varda Shrivastava, product manager, and JinMan on principal software engineering manager. Hi, you guys.
Hey, you.
So before we get talking about performance insights, which I'm excited to hear about, tell us a little bit about your journey to the team you're on now and kind of what you've done in Microsoft to get here.
I started my career in Microsoft in 2000, and then almost 2 decades so far.
Yeah.
And I also onboarded on Dynamics 7 years ago. Since then, I focused on performance of a Dynamics platform. That's me.
And Varda?
Awesome. Yeah. So I'm a PM on the Power Apps platform team. I started my Microsoft journey as an intern, actually. I was a software engineering intern at OneDrive, and I joined the Power platform team last year.
And today, you guys are both focusing on performance, right? And I know, JinMan, I've called you many times when I've had an app that wasn't performing like we wanted to, and you could look under the covers and tell us what was happening for real. The feature you're describing today is going to let everybody do that for their model-driven apps. Talk a little more about it.
Yeah. So performance, as you know, continues to be a top ask from the Power Platform. While we continue to make investments as a platform on improving perf, we really wanted to create a self-service tool that would allow our makers to improve the performance of their model-driven apps.
So can we take a look at it?
Yeah, for sure.
Yeah, sure.
The front door for this feature is going to be on make.powerapps, the maker portal. And what you're going to want to do is go to the app list. From this point, you can select any model-driven app, any enterprise-level app that you want to see these insights for. And then either through the command bar or through the context menu, click on performance. And this will take you to the performance insights grid, which essentially displays analyzed telemetry data that has a prioritized list of recommendations and insights. From here, you can click on any specific category that you want to deep dive into. So we can look at deprecated controls, and it'll give you more information about the motivation of this insight, what the new recommendation is, as well as it'll link you to our documentation that will provide you more information about how you can actually improve performance for the specific category. For these, we're actually analyzing runtime telemetry data over a 24-hour period. You can select a date up to 7 days prior to view past insights as well.
This is different than some of the performance-related capabilities that are currently in model-driven apps, right? Like, how is it different?
So we have tools like Solution Checker that analyze static code analysis. But Perf Insights is different because we're looking at actual runtime telemetry data. So for this feature, using it in a production org, which has a lot of usage, is going to be most beneficial because you're going to be able to look at analyzed telemetry data.
And so this telemetry data is what we have on our servers on how the app was running and maybe how could it run better?
Yeah, that's true. Although a lot of pre-canned tools and also checkers help customers to identify some of the performance issues put in place from the dev period when they launched it, right? That kind of application is going to be used by different users on different locations, and also the server might have a different situation along the way of usage. So we try to collect a certain telemetry data from client all the way server side. And then based on this live telemetry data, we start analyzing to harvest some insight out of. And then if this kind of insight relates with something that customer can do a little bit of work on, so as to make the performance fast, so as to make better user experience, we need to have a certain channel to tell this kind of insight back to customer.
Yeah, it's a shame to have all that data, not be able to share it with the people that can actually make a change to their app and benefit from it.
Exactly.
And I think a problem we're having too is that our makers weren't really aware of what runtime performance issues they faced because they didn't have access to this information. So
or even know that they had the power to even change it. So this is in public preview now, so people can start using this now. What's planned? What's next for this?
So we're continuously going to be adding more insights as this becomes a platform. Different teams will be adding insights to this. We'll have a richer set of categories that people can deep dive into.
People are trying this out. How do they get that feedback to you?
Yeah, so we're going to create a post on the Power Apps community channel, and then we'll start a thread there where you can leave your feedback.
Okay, so we'll link to that in the description, and you just go there, and then you guys will get the feedback directly.
Yeah, like that way, they will see some sort of low-hanging fruit from the performance insight. Some other insight might require a little bit of time to change some code here and there. However, again, it will give them a certain benefit back.
At least you have the direction to go.
Exactly, yeah. So we will keep evolving our document as well. We want to provide a very granular step-by-step of instruction so that not just IT pro, but also someone who owns that area in the certain specific tenant, that they should be able to follow the instruction that we provide from the document perspective. So eventually they can make their user experience better from their side as well.
Better apps for everybody.
Yeah. Good
call. Thank you. Thank you so much for taking the time to show this brand new capability. I'm really excited about it.
Thank you.
Thanks, Bill.